What is going on, everybody? How is everybody doing today? And we are back here today on 2K19 with a challenge rebuild, and it's going to be the Siri rebuild. So basically, this challenge is I'm going to do a fantasy draft, and I'm going to ask Siri to pick a number between 1 and 20, and the first 20 players we see at our available pick, whatever Siri says is who I draft. And then when we want to trade players, I got to go with Siri, pick a number between 1 and how many like trade finder offers I get. And that offer is the one I have to do. So yeah, this challenge is going to be controlled by a virtual, I guess, voice. So this is going to be very annoying. We are going to be picking our team here. I'm going to randomly just close my eyes and just stop it in 3, 2, 1. We get the Atlanta Hawks. Okay, funny enough, this is where I can maybe do a quick plug. On my second channel, I'm doing a realistic My League series with the Hawks. Link in the description. You can go check that out. So we have the Hawks. What pick are we going to have? Please don't be low. Okay, this is actually really early, so we are going to be picking 8. Oh my god, this is actually really nice. Siri, please don't mess this up. Hey Siri, pick a number between 1 and 20. Please, give me something.
The answer is 15.
15! Oh my god. Oh, why couldn't you say something in the top 5? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Oh my god! Oh! We were one away from Kristaps, and we have to draft on Marcus Aldridge. Come on. All right, so back on the clock here in the second round. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 20.
The answer is 9.
9, okay. I would have liked this last time, but we got 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, my God. One away from Markkanen and Hassan Whiteside and Marcus Aldridge are our first two picks. Bro. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 20.
The answer is
3. I would have liked that in the first round. So we're going to get DeAndre Jordan. Really. I would have rather if you said 4. Oh, or maybe like 7 or 8. Oh, my God. So we got to draft DeAndre Jordan. So we have a Marcus Aldridge, Hassan Whiteside, and DeAndre Jordan. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 20.
The answer is 2.
2. Tristan Thompson. Are we just going to have only centers on our team? That I feel like that's the way this is going to go. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 20.
The answer is 15.
Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Joe Harris is 15. All right, at least we're getting non-centers. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 20.
The answer is 6.
6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and DeLon Wright. Yay, we get a point guard. All right, so this team is moving along. I'm going to keep doing this, and I'll see you guys with what the final team is going to look like. Okay, so we just finished a draft. Let's obviously exit here. Oh my god, we're gonna have literally the worst record in the league this year. I think we're gonna be contending for the number one overall pick. All right, so let's look at the roster. Point guard, we have DeLon Wright and DJ Augustine. Oh, and we're paying DJ Augustine 7 mil this year and next year too. Shooting guards, we have Tony Allen and Kyle Korver. Immediately, Tony Allen is going to small forward. I just spoiled the rest of the roster. Nice. So shooting guard, Korver, small forward, Joe Harris, Tony Allen, and Kenrich Williams. Power forward, Tyler Wyden. Oh my god, LaMarcus Aldridge. I gotta change him to a power forward because this can't happen. And at center, yeah, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 centers. Oh, Aldridge, Whiteside, DeAndre. Oh my god. DeAndre's in a free agent. So is Whiteside. So two of our top picks are freaking free agents at the end of this year. So maybe I can move them like DeAndre Jordan now. All right, guys. So I almost didn't realize that I had to use Siri if I wanted to do a trade finder trade. So if we do throw up DeAndre Jordan, let's see how many offers we get. And then I have to ask Siri what number. And then she can tell me which trade we can accept. So we got 23 offers. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 23.
The answer is 2.
2. All right. So let's see some other of these offers we could have got, okay? Derrick Rose could have been nice, obviously, Otto Porter wouldn't have been that bad, but I think we had to give up a pick. So pick 2, okay, most of these are garbage, is going to be Monte Morris. You know what? That's not terrible. I will actually take that. He would be a nice bench player. So you know what? That is the best thing Siri has done for me. So this is going to be the rotation this year. It's Morris, Korver, Harris, Aldridge, Whiteside, Thompson, DeLon Wright, Kaminsky, Augustine. I got no young players on this team. Because Siri drafted such a crappy team. I'm expecting a top pick in the draft. I'll see you guys at the end of season number 1. All right, so James Harden of the Milwaukee Bucks wins MVP. And for some reason, we go 44-38. That makes no sense. Maybe it's true. If you just have a ton of big men on your team, you just do well in 2K. I really don't get it. Ennis Kanter, sixth man of the year in Memphis. Giannis, defensive player of the year in Phoenix. Jamal Murray, most improved in Sacktown. And Billy Donovan gets Coach of the Year. Okay. I don't think we'll see LaMarcus Aldridge make this. What team are we again with the Hawks? Oh, my God, he does. All-NBA second team. Oh, my God. I got to sell high. I got to trade him if his value is going to be this good. Oh, my God. 25 points a game, 9 rebounds. Jeez. Oh, my God. That's a career high for LaMarcus. All right. And we're probably going to see no other Hawks, it looks like. All right. So, we are a 5 seed in the Eastern Conference. That really shocked me. If we take a look at the stats, yeah, Aldridge was a beast. And then we had Whiteside, who's testing free agency, average a double-double. Augustine, who I did give a 2-year extension to. Actually, I don't know why, but I'm going to trade him this offseason. Same with Tristan Thompson, who I also gave one to as well. And yeah, here's pretty much everyone. Korver, Harris, Kaminsky, Thompson, Monte, DeLon. I don't know how this team won 44 games, but it did. Milwaukee's roster, Anthony Simmons, James Harden. Oh, okay, we're not winning. Wow, and they have DeAndre Jordan, of course. Jaren Jackson Jr. and Gilbert Harden's a pretty nice big three, especially in a fantasy draft. So I expect to lose this, and somehow we're up 2. How? You know, I'm not complaining. We're up 3-0. 3-1. Can we win in 5? Okay, can we win in 6? Do not blow a 3. Okay, we somehow win in 6. And now we're taking on the 1-seeded Pacers, who have Trae Young, Jaylen Brown, Isaac, and I'm just going to guess a really good center in Kat. Damn. All right. This team is really good. If we beat them, I don't really know what to say. We win game one. We win game... What is going on? 2-1? 3-1 us. Oh, my God. Are we going to the conference finals? Oh, my God. We won 4-2. I fully expected to have a top 5 pick in this draft. Now we're taking on the Nets, who have Kyrie McCollum. It's a bonus. All right. I mean, that's still another team that's better than us, but we've been playing so well, and we're down 2-0. Okay, the road ends here. That was the luckiest season I think I've ever had in my life. I don't even know if I'm happy because now our draft pick is going to be so low. So Minnesota wins it all, and Clint Capella is your finals MVP. They had D'Lo, Capella, Gordon, Barnes, Favors. All right. Very shocked that team won it all. So for the lottery, for the draft, I'm going to do like 1-8 because 1-20, I feel like I don't want to draft a guy 20 spots lower than I should. So draft lottery, I'm definitely going to try to move up in the draft. So let's see. We get... pick. Where are we? We are 20 in this year's draft. So, I mean, Lloyd Pierce brought us to the conference final, so I can't really fire him, but, I mean, he couldn't get fired next year. Who knows? Melvin Hunt, okay, and then we'll sign like Owen Masters as our assistant GM. I'm cool with that. So, we get both of them. All right, so NBA draft time. Now, I could use Trade Finder, which I'm going to do for a couple trades, because, you know, that's fun, because we don't know what trade we're going to be able to use. But I'm going to do an initial, go to the trade just to get a good draft pick. So, if I threw up Tristan Thompson and DJ Augustine on the block, we got 15 offers. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 15. 2. All right, that took a minute. So, we get a first-round pick. All right. Oh, my God, this is perfect. A salary dump and a future first. Wow. I would have liked this Bam trade maybe, this Knicks trade, but you know what? I'll take that. So, we get pick 2 again, or trade 2 again, so we do that. Now, what I'm going to do is try to move up in this draft. I don't think I'm going to give up Aldridge, but if I could give up, Joe Harris... Let's see. Zizic. Okay, Joe Harris has 2.5 stars. Can I trade Joe Harris, Zizic, 20th pick in our second round pick for pick 7 from the Spurs? They agree to that. 2K, you gotta fix the draft capital. I guess, this offseason, first round picks definitely diminished in value because people are just setting off their future first round picks for, it's nothing. But, that shouldn't happen in 2K20. Okay, so I'm gonna do... pick 1-7, so we could get a guy that's best available or 7 spots down. So please, 2K, or Siri, give me some luck. Hey, Siri, pick a number between 1 and 7.
It's 5.
5, okay. Ugh, I don't know who this guy is. Tyrese, oh my God, I would have liked if it was a little bit lower. But we are going to get a Tyrese Haliburton from Iowa State. I don't know how to feel. So, I would have liked a Nico Mannion or something like that, but I don't see it. Nico Mannion fell all the way to 25. Wow. All right. So, yeah. He's a 75 overall. That's not terrible. Maybe he'll be good for us. So, actually, Whiteside opts in. All right. So, does Baines. I'm not going to bring back any of these guys. And Korver, no, I'm not going to bring him back. So, it's free agency time. We should have cap space. I'm going to give both these guys the qualifying offers. Let me just see what free agency is going to look like. Is KD going to be here? And stuff like that. And, Clay and stuff. Because it should be the 2019 offseason. Yeah, so there are some good free agents. I do want to see, I don't know if I'm going to move him, but what could I get for, Aldridge on the block? Is his value really high that I can get an all-star caliber player, or would I be really just selling low on him? Even though his value is really high, do I want to have the risk of getting this trade? There's probably, this trade, which is nice, but I have to randomly do this. RJ Hampton. Oh, my God. You know what? I'm scheming the Siri system. Who drafted RJ Hampton? Because I'm going to do that trade. Wait, Mike Conley? Interesting. Because RJ Hampton's a beast in this, and yeah, I would be saving 20 mil, which will allow me, if I move Whiteside, I think to get two max deals. So the Utah Jazz, I'm going to do this in a manual trade, because you know what? This is a huge move. I want to be able to pull this off. Aldridge to the Jazz for Hampton. Okay, I will also give you Aaron Baines. They agree to that. Okay, so we pick him up, which is very clean. From now on, I'm not going to do any of those. I just want to do a big one because it was me trading Aldridge. So I'm going to move Whiteside, I think. Wait, do I have two max skills even if I don't move Whiteside? Huh, I might. Okay, so who should I go after? Let me see here. Okay, so I offer deals to Jimmy Butler and Tobias Harris. Let's see if both sign with us. Okay, Kaminsky from the Bulls. All right, whatever. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to sign Jimmy Butler and Tobias Harris. I don't know if I can sign Frank Kaminsky, so I don't want... Yeah, I can't sign Frank Kaminsky. And I can't bring back DeLon... Wait, I can probably bring back DeLon Wright. Maybe? I don't know. Okay, I can bring back DeLon Wright. Nice. So I'm going to do that. So I'm going to sign Jimmy Butler and Tobias Harris. Two huge signings to go along with Whiteside and RJ Hampton. And you don't need, like, a stud roster in these because all these rosters are particularly balanced for the most part because it's a fantasy draft. It's a serpentine or snake fantasy draft. So we do get those guys. And like I said, I do want to bring back DeLon Wright on a deal, so we are going to do that. And do I have maybe a mid-level exception to use on someone solid? So I'm going to sign DeLon Wright to a three-year deal, and then I did offer Tyreek Evans a two-year deal. He is in this game, so yeah. We are going to have him probably start at the two. So if we look at our roster real quick, we have four point guards. So I think I'm going to end up moving a couple of these. So yeah, I might move just Wright, or maybe I'll move two. I don't know. Shooting guards, Evans, small forward, Butler, power forward, Harris, center. Yeah, so we definitely need a backup big man. I'm going to throw up DeLon Wright on the block. I hope I can get something good for him. Okay, there's a couple centers. All right, decent amount of centers getting offered. 16. Please give me something good. Pick a number between 1 and 16.
The answer is 13.
13. All right, what is 13? Ugh. Oh, this trade is not that good. All right, so Lucas whatever is going to be our backup center. Unless we can find somebody that's good in free agency, that's probably better. All right, I'll sign Kyle Quinn. He might be better than that guy, so I'll see you guys at training camp. All right, so we do have three on top potential, so I'm going to send it definitely to RJ Hampton. I have high hopes for him. I don't know if, like, Halberton could end up being a two or maybe even RJ. How tall is he? 6'5", maybe? I don't know. I'm going to definitely send it to him, so he's at an A-. And then we'll send, I don't know, we'll send, like, offensive something. We'll send perimeter shooting to, like, Jimmy Butler. Because I don't really have anything else to do. So, yeah, Jimmy Butler is going to be our best player. Let's hope for the best. If we do bad this year, maybe we're going to trade Jimmy Butler in the offseason. All right, so here's how the rotation is going to go. We got 34 to RJ, 29 to Tyreek Evans, 36 to Butler and Harris, 33 to Whiteside, and then we have 25 to Morris, 22 to Halberton, 15 to Hutchinson, and then 10 to Lucas. System proficiency, 3.5 stars is balanced. That's fine with me. And then our preseason power ranking, let's see, is going to be number, 23. That hurts. I'll see you guys at the end of the year. We made it to the Eastern Conference Finals last year. Let's hope for maybe some repeat of some sort like that this year. All right, so we end the season with a 47-35 record. James Harden wins back-to-back MVPs. Another James wins Rookie of the Year. He kind of looks like Jimmy Butler. Actually, not really. I don't know. Ennis Kanter, Sixth Man of the Year. Giannis, Defensive Player of the Year again. Tobias Harris, Most Improved. That's what I'm talking about. He dropped 21-9, 40% from three, 49 from the field, 89 from the line. I'll take that. And James Borrego gets Coach of the Year. So we got no Hawks. Yeah, no Hawks. We might get, I was going to say we probably will get RJ Hampton on Rookie 15, on All Rookie First Team. 15 points, 5.7 assists. And then no Hawks on All-Rookie Second Team. So, this year we are a 3 seed, taking on the New York Knicks in round one. The Knicks have De'Aaron Fox, Shasta Koji. Okay. Oh my god! Draymond Carter Jr., Randall Kawhi Fox. How are they a 6th? We're not beating them. There's no shot we beat that team. That team is way too freaking good. I mean, Jimmy Butler, 18 points, 5 assists. RJ Hampton, 15, we saw his. Tyreek Evans actually was pretty good. Whiteside, 13 and 15, might have to re-sign him. And then our bench was really, All right, I'm fully expecting a first-round exit, because why do we have to take on Kawhi Leonard, De'Aaron Fox, Tremont Green, Julius Randle, and we're tied 2-2. Can we go up 3-2? Yes. Can we not blow a 3-2 lead? Game 7, we went back and forth. Oh, my God, of course. We win, we lose, we win, we lose, we win, we lose, and then we just have to keep the cycle going But no, we lose two in a row. So Minnesota goes back to back, and Clint Capela is your Finals MVP as they beat the Celtics in seven. I don't know really what to do. Do I move Butler? So we have the 25th pick in the draft. Like, nothing too crazy. I'm going to fire Borrego. I'm at Void Pierce. Nothing like a shot on him. It's just I can get somebody with way better ratings, like a Jacob Underwood. So I'm going to do that. So let's go to the draft. I don't plan on really drafting somebody high, but I just want to see if I threw up on the block Jimmy Butler and, like, Halliburton. Okay, wouldn't get anything from there. All right, Jimmy Butler. Oh, my God. Like, see, I would love that trade, but there's a chance I can get this trade. Like, this is too big of a risk to move him. Like, Oladipo. Oh, I would do that. DeRozan, not really. All right, there's a couple better good trades. There's, like, I would say two. Two out of 15 is not worth it, so we're going to keep Jimmy. So we did draft Kumar Ballo, and then Charles O'Bannon Jr., so those are our two new rookies. We have Monte Morris and Chandler Hutchinson coming back. Qualifying offers, none. And then let's go to Moratorium, where I don't think we'll have any cap space. But like I said, I do want to bring back Whiteside. I thought he was fairly good for us, at least stats-wise. I mean, we're not getting an eye test in this because I'm not playing these games. So we are going to bring back Whiteside on that. Can I afford a backup center? Oof, I can also afford it. Okay, no, I can't until I sign Whiteside. Damn it. Okay, so we're about to sign Whiteside, and we do. So let's see what centers I can afford. I'll bring in Daniel Tice on a 3-year deal. Decent amount of money on an AAV. So it's like 8.5 AAV, I think. So, you know what? That could be used in a trade. But like I said, it's such a huge risk to trade people because I don't know what Siri is going to make me do. So we do pick up Tice. I think I should move one of my point guards. So if I were to move Halliburton, like, what could I get? If I did him in next year's Bucks first, sure. Maybe that pick has value. Okay, so Burden's got 3 stars. All right, there's some, yeah. Like this, oh, I don't want to give up Whiteside. Okay, I'm going to do this. 18 offers, but there's a thing here. I can only do offers that only have Burden and picks. If, like, Whiteside's in there, then I'm not doing them because that's just not what I signed up for. Pick a number between 1 and 18.
It's 8.
8. All right, please be a good trade. 8. Okay, I can't do this trade because it has Whiteside. All right, let's do this again.
That would be 13.
All right, 13 this time. Oh, my. You know what? I'll do this trade. I don't really care about Charles O'Bannon. So we're getting Scotty Lewis, who's a good 2, and Adam Miller had some decent trade value. So are we set for next year's season? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, we're good for next year. All right, so we do have 3 on top potentials. I'm going to definitely send RJ Hampton, even though I think he could have been already an A+. Anybody else? I guess Scotty Lewis, if he's going to maybe start at the 2 for us. Wow, so Adam Miller was the 9th overall pick in 2020. Interesting. So we got a top 10 pick in that Halliburton trade. Okay, so here's the lineup. We got 35 to Hampton, 33 to Lewis, 35 to Butler, 35 to Harris, 32 to Whiteside. And then on the bench, we got 24 to Morris, 20 to Tice, 16 to Evans, and then 10 to Hutchinson. I do have Miller in the G League. Since the proficiency, obviously I got to change defense to nothing is 4 stars, so I'll just go to balance, sure. And then our preseason power ranking is going to be 3 on NBA.com. All right. I'll see you guys at the end of the year. Let's hopefully maybe be finals contenders this year. All right, guys. So we end season number 3 with technically our best record yet. We go 48-34. James Harden, 3-peats in MVP. So he's really good there. James Borrego, coach of the year again for the Hornets. So they're really good. I don't know if we'll see any Hawks here in the All-NBA teams. We do not. What about all defensive? Nope. And all rookie? No. So we are a 5-seed in the Eastern Conference. That hurts. I'm going to have to probably trade Jimmy Butler or Tobias Harris if we don't win it all, or maybe Whiteside. Yeah, that is really disappointing to be a 5-seed. So Tobias Harris, 18. What happened to 21 from last year? Why'd you go down, my guy? RJ Hampton, 17.5 and 6 assists. Maybe I should have kept Aldridge. I don't know. There's Jimmy Butler, 17, 4.5, 4.5. Scotty Lewis, 16 and 90. Shot 33 from 3. There's Whiteside, 10 and 13. Tyreek, Tice, Morris, and Hutchinson. All right. So they have D-Rose, Bradley Beal. I mean, Bradley Beal and Cousins are really good, but like their team outside of that doesn't have like a third really good player, but they are surrounded by like really good role players. And you know what? They are the 4th seed. So we're up 2-0. Okay, that's huge. Can we go up 3-0? Okay. Round 1's looking pretty good, and we sweep the Philadelphia 76ers. So now we're taking on the 1-seeded Celtics, who have, oh my god, DeJounte Murray, Donovan Mitchell, Kevin Durant? How do they have Donovan Mitchell and Kevin Durant? Donovan Mitchell was a 2nd-round pick, right? Or did they sign KD? Maybe they signed KD. No, they didn't. Okay. No, they did, from Miami. Wow, okay. So yeah, that hurts. Oh my god, this is not going to work out right for us. Oh, damn it. Oh, they were so close to losing in round 1. and they embarrassed the shit out of us.